Hello guys, welcome to my kitchen once again. Today we'll make seafood risotto. I will show you the proper way, the Greek way to cook the perfect risotto with seafood. And let's start cooking. And let's start by preheating our non-stick pan. It's smoking, so I will add some olive oil and my shrimps. Just give nice color, 1 minute each side. Nice golden brown color. And my shrimps are ready. The pan back again to the heat. A bit more olive oil. And we add the calamari. The same, not more than 1 minute. Give it a nice color. Can you see that? And the calamari is also ready. Take it off. I need an onion and I will dice it. Take your time and chop your onion. I have 2 celery stalks and 1 carrot. I will dice them. And I will carry on with the celery. Dice them also. 1 clove of garlic. And it's time to start cooking our vegetables. You will start with extra virgin Greek olive oil. And all the vegetables. Onion, carrots, celery, and the garlic. And this is the beauty of Greece. You're cooking and you're watching that. This is amazing. You need to let them caramelize. I will help them a little bit with some sugar. And lower the heat. Leave some time to the vegetables to take all these lovely flavors inside the risotto after. Cook them for about 5 minutes. My vegetables are ready. Can you see that caramelization? This will make our risotto very, very tasty. Back to the heat and it's time to add Mr. Risotto. And just saute the rice for a bit to make it translucent. My rice seems ready. And it's time to add Mr. White Wine. And you have to be patient, wait until it evaporates. And when the wine evaporates, we will start adding our vegetable stock. Don't pour over lots of stock. Just 2 spoonfuls is enough for start to cover the rice and the vegetables and slow cook the rice. After the first batch of stock, when it evaporates, we will add some more. So you have to continue this process for at least 4 to 5 times until the rice is ready. And now it's time to taste a bit of my rice. It is almost ready, needs about 2-3 more minutes, so it's time to add the seafood. I will add my calamari and my prawns. I will add the mussels. And I will add some lovely clams. Those should be enough. Now, I will just add 1 last ladleful of stock. Then I will cover my pan for 2 more minutes. And after that, I will uncover, I will reveal my risotto, and I will put my final touches. And it's time to reveal my risotto. As you can see, there is a lot of moisture inside the risotto because all the seafood release a lot of moisture, but this is exactly what we want, this flavor from the seafood. Now, take off the heat, and it's time to add some final touches. Some rosemary. The zest of 1 lemon. And the juice of 1/2 lemon. And just a bit of mascarpone. Now, we mix the risotto. Can you see that? It is amazing. Please do not overcook the seafood. Just put it at the end and trust me, you will have all this lovely flavor from the seafood. I will add a bit more salt. Oh my God, it's really delicious. Pepper, lots of pepper. And it's time to serve. I will take another spoon and I will start with these lovely mussels, with this lovely calamari, with these lovely prawns, with these lovely clams. I will add some wild rocket to the top. I will drizzle some extra virgin Greek olive oil, freshly ground pepper, and it's ready to be eaten. Everything in a bite. Oh my God, you actually can taste the sea. If you liked that video, please subscribe to my channel. Yeah, make comments underneath the video. Share with your friends, thumbs up. See you next time. Kisses from Greece. Bye bye. Γεια σας.